everyone. We're here again. I hope you all... My paper. Never mind. I had words to say, but I left them inside. I'll say them next week. Very overwhelmed with lots of good news happening at the moment. I hope you all had a good week. Take care. Look after yourselves. See you. And here's the rabbi. Mazal Tov.
Hello. It's so nice to be able to speak on the Parasha of the week, Parashat Ekev. Before that, I wanted to express ourselves to wish Mazal Tov to Avi Amon and Naama Schwartz. Just got engaged.
This is hot off the press. They just got engaged
so
in Central Park.
We are so happy for them.
Mazal Tov.
And I want to wish Jeff Amon and Dalia. Amon Mazal Tov, and to the entire family, the
keep
grandparents
the,
as okay. well here.
Keep the good news coming.
That's it. Vedrat Hashem.
Okay.
So now, the parasha of the week. As you know, this parasha now is Ekev, and Moshe Rabbeinu is continuing speaking to the children of Israel to encourage them as they are about to enter the promised land soon, even though he knows he's going to stay behind. But no better person than Moshe Rabbeinu, who really, even though he is not going to achieve the dream of his life to go with them into Eretz Israel, he's full of blessing and good words. And he makes some amazing statement because he starts giving the people of Israel many mitzvot, many commandments. He's mentioning them, so many of the commandments, and there are 613. But at the end, he's saying one thing. But now, what do you think God is requesting from you? He is requiring from you what he wants from you to do. He said, Kim le'yira et Hashem Elokecha kol hayamim. To fear him every day. Now, it's very difficult to grasp that, to say that the entire thing is of what God really wants from you, that is to fear him. Now, what is the point of fearing God? Do you think that God wants that we should fear him? That's it? And is that a trip that God wants to have, like, you know, the Wizard of Oz, you know, is that what it is you want to fear? Or you think that by fearing God, then he becomes greater? What is the purpose of this mitzvah among the 613? This is what it is mentioning. Kim le'ira et Hashem Elokecha. So I think that we have to understand it from the context of the etymological meaning of the word to fear, because we many times when we are reading tefillah, and we have to emphasize to people to make sure that they don't make the mistake when they say the word ra'ah or yir'ah, because sometimes is ve'yareta ve'yire, meaning to see or to fear. Fear and seeing, it practically they are integrated, they are the same from the same root etymologically. And what does it say? It say because we fear when we see something. You know the saying that what you don't see, you don't fear. And so therefore is related what God, what Moshe Rabbeinu is saying, that you have to have a certain awareness of the consequences or whatever it is that you do. That's what it means, le'yir'ah et Hashem Elokecha. Constantly you have to be aware of what could come out of whatever you do, because that will stop you from performing mitzvot if you don't really think about consequences, is good or bad. And that's what the word is. And and so what that God wants from us is to really understand and appreciate the reality of things, not be delusional, not start creating thinking and dreaming about things without realizing the reality of it all. For example, you know, when we talk about relationship, for example. Can you imagine? You know that you create a relationship with somebody for quite a time. All of a sudden, you realize that this relationship is not going anywhere, is not going to succeed. You know it, but you create the illusion to yourself because you need it, and you say everything is okay. But it's not true, because the reality is not so. In the same thing, when it comes to something like that, other things that in your life, you also think, for example, you commit something, you do something that is wrong. You know that what you do is wrong, and you have to change course. But you know what? It's so humiliating, it's so difficult to admit that I am wrong, that I create the illusion that it's wonderful, everything is okay, but it's not so. In the same thing with everything that we have, we try many times to think that it is one way, but the reality is not so. And so you start to create that illusion. You start blaming other people, put it on other people. You say, oh, your parents, they have got a fault, whatever it is that you do, in reality you don't want to admit. Oh, perhaps your spouse, or perhaps God, perhaps your friend, who knows? The idea is what God is saying, to fear God, is because you know what is right, and you know what is wrong. And therefore, that is the reality. And what God wants you to be is to be honest. And honesty is the greatest thing, that how you can serve God with honesty. So with honesty, we hope that, please God, every one of us get to be really honest in everything that we do, everything that we feel. And le'ira et Hashem Elokecha, to fear God, meaning to serve Him with that reality that we know, that is so true and is so honest. Shabbat Shalom.